of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate the great solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. This is the highest and the greatest of all mysteries, because it is God, three persons and one God. The triune God lives and dwells in us through our baptism. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, the day of your baptism, dwell within you and dwell in you forever. In our first reading from the book of Exodus, Moses goes up on the mountaintop, Mount Sinai, and there before the Lord appears and he cries out to Moses and to us, the Lord is merciful, gracious, slow to anger, kind, faithful. But the very first attribute is the greatest, is God's mercy. No matter how far we go away, no matter how low we fall, that we can always turn to the Lord in his mercy. Let us ask for that mercy now as we begin this Mass. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison.
Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison.
Christ Jesus, you call all to share your glory. Christe, Christe, eleison.
Christe, Christe, eleison.
Lord Jesus, you reveal your Father's love to all in the world.
Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison. Kyrie, Kyrie, eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
For your grace, glory, Lord God, heavenly
us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. He came down in a cloud. The Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity. Moses at once bowed down to the ground and worshiped. Then he said, if I find favor with you, Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Yet pardon our wickedness and sins and receive us as your own. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, let our response be, glory and praise forever.
Glory
and praise forever. Blessed are you, Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. And blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and glorious above all forever. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you in the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forever.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice. Mend your ways. Encourage one another. Agree with one another. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God And the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, for he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Unity in Trinity. Today is the great solemnity of the Holy Trinity, and it's a day to think about what we most need, I think, right now. Unfortunately, in our world, in our country, in our communities, we need more unity. We wonder, when will all our sad divisions cease? All of the division that we have in our society, it's very sad. But today on the Feast of the Trinity, we see this unity in Trinity. There's more than one, but they're able to get along and to be united. We pray for that, and we hope that we'll have unity. You know, when the pandemic first hit, I was kind of feeling sort of happy to see that everyone could agree on something. Everybody was agreeing, I want to live, I don't want to die. And everybody there was kind of a unity, maybe a common enemy, you know, right? The virus. And so everybody forgot about all the political tensions, it seemed like, for a couple of weeks, maybe. But unfortunately, the divisions have returned with a vengeance, many times along political lines. This is all very sad. So obviously the pandemic wasn't the answer. Pandemic wasn't the solution. We need another solution. I propose that the solution is the Spirit. The Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit's like the glue that binds the Holy Trinity together. The Father and the Son are united by the love of the Holy Spirit. So what we need is a spirit of unity, don't we, in our world, in our country. You know, in the seminary, I remember a professor gave us a definition of spirit. And there's different spirits, right? There's divine spirits, right? The divine persons. There's angelic spirits, and then there's human spirits. But what is a spirit? A spirit, or spirit in general, is that which unites. That which unites several elements without the individual elements losing their individuality. So you've got this unity in, you know, plurality. In pluribus unum, right, we say in our country. Even in our common speech, we're used to using the word spirit kind of as a way of uniting, right? Team spirit. You know, maybe the professional sports are going to start up again. Team spirit, we all know, you see, if a team is working in unison, right, then there's a certain spirit. They're all individuals, but they're working as one. Or we talk about, you know, like at a party, you say, this party is dead. All these individuals, and they're all in their own corners. But what would it be if a party has a certain party spirit, where we're all individuals, but there's a oneness. We're all somehow, and there's a synergy, and it's more than the sum of the parts. And then, of course, in this country, we talk about, and we've been talking about, the spirit of 76. It used to be a gas station. But the spirit of 76 was a saying for 1776, this spirit of uniting. Actually, in 1775, Benjamin Franklin published a political cartoon showing this need to unite, this spirit that they needed in the Revolutionary War. Originally, one of the symbols of the United States was not an eagle; it was a rattlesnake or a snake. They even proposed putting rattlesnakes in the gardens of all the British politicians in the colonies. But the snake, and so they even had a flag for some time. Don't tread on me, a snake, you know, don't step on. But Benjamin Franklin published this cartoon, which was Join or Die, a political cartoon. It was an article about how they needed to unite, actually against the French at that time. They needed to unite or die, the colonies. So there was this drawing of a snake that was cut into pieces. And we need to get together. They had an old superstition back then that if you cut a snake up, but you put the pieces together, that it would come back to life before nightfall. It's kind of a strange belief they had, but this was, if we unite, we can live. And so that was the spirit of 76. There's 13 colonies, but we're all one. 1 and 13, not 1 and 3, 1 and 13. That's the original. And our flag has 13 stripes, right? And then 50 stars. We're plurality, but we're one. There's a lot of talk now about the flag and whether it represents something good or bad, or controversy about that. And it's unfortunate because one of the early flags was that snake. Don't tread on me. We are united. Hopefully that is the case. Hopefully that is the fact. So that's common parlance in, general way of speaking. We use the word spirit to talk about things that are many but one, and how they work together. Well, in theology, in our religion, we also see that the word spirit indicates something that can unite. For example, the soul, the human soul, we're body and soul. Well, our soul is a spirit. We're bodily spirits. Embodied spirit. So our soul is a spirit. And sure enough, the spirit that we have, our soul, is capable of uniting with matter, with something material, with a physical body. How's that possible? Well, spirit can do anything that has to do with uniting. So our bodies and our souls are one, substantially united. So someone touches me and they say, I touched your arm, and I say, no, you touched me. And both are true, because it is me. This is me, because my body is me. The soul and the body are in the same place in a certain sense. And then there's other spirits which aren't embodied, that aren't substantially conjoined with matter. There are spirits that are angelic spirits. God also created angels. And angels are spirits that do not have bodies, and they're not anything united to matter. But nevertheless, they can be intellectually, and they collaborate with one another. Angels are not everywhere. They exist only where they act, only where they impose or apply their will. So an angel you know, is not in space and time, but wherever it acts or does something, that's where it is. And then, you know, demons are fallen angels. And so they're not everywhere either. They're not everywhere. They can only be one place at a time, right? And so that's consoling, right? But the word devil means divide. He's the one who divides. Diabolo, you know, diaphragm, diagonal means something that divides. And so the devil wants to divide us from God and from each other. And so that's the devil. But luckily, he's not, you know, a divine spirit. He's an angelic spirit, so he's limited, very limited. And he is nothing compared to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is God. The Holy Spirit is everywhere. And so we can be comforted that the Holy Spirit of unity and the Holy Spirit unites the Father and the Son. I won't go on too long in my homily because I actually put up another video today about the Trinity and about that fact that the Holy Spirit can unite and unites the Father and the Son. And so let us pray for that solution, for that Holy Spirit to come and to unite us, to be the Spirit of love and charity and peace. The Lord is the Prince of Peace. We Christians, we Catholics have the solution. We have it. Hopefully it's a spirit of love, a spirit of acceptance of all people, of all nations, of all races. And so our Lord, the Prince of Peace, and Our Lady, right? Our Lady gave us the solution. We know as Catholics, we've got the peace plan from heaven. Our Lady said, she said, I am the Lady of the Rosary, but she is the Lady of Peace who came to warn us about the 20th century. And she spoke of peace. But also, you know, ordinary time is a time for celebrating all the mysteries. We can think about all the mysteries. So I'd just like to conclude actually with something about the Prince of Peace who came at Christmas. Our Lord came at Christmas. And in Advent, we have a beautiful hymn that we sing that describes that desire that we have, that our sad divisions will cease. O come, desire of nations, bind in one the hearts of all mankind. Bid all our sad divisions cease, and be yourself our Prince of Peace.
United in our faith, let us profess together, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and light for the world to come. Amen. Having heard the word of God, let us now call upon our Father who made us, the Son who redeemed us, and the Holy Spirit who renews us.
That God will guide the Christian churches in their search for unity, so that their oneness will show forth the love of the Trinity, and that dedicated men and women will respond to God's call to the priesthood, diaconate, and consecrated life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will strengthen civil authorities in their efforts to reestablish justice and peace, and that racism and violence in our cities will cease, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will remove every fear from our human hearts and fill them with that perfect love that comes from God alone, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will build up this community of the faithful and make us dynamic disciples, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will help all gathered here to grow in the life of the Holy Trinity by our celebration of the Eucharist, including Jeanette Toloi on her birthday, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will bring those who have died, including Rita Cabana, Jean Medeiros, Ricardo Estrada, the Sanchez Montes family, Maxima Rojo, Ronald Segarini, Michael Angelo Bonetti, Sofrono Lapitan, Richard Carl Bersig, Mike DeToro, Jim Harnois, and those who have died from the coronavirus, that they may enter into the joy of the Trinity in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, let the love that unites the persons of the Holy Trinity shape our lives and the lives of all people. Fulfill now, we pray, our longings, so that we will witness the majesty and glory of your name as it transcends the earth and fills the heavens. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity and substance, and their equal and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim. Merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Myron, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we've been erected, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, in blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles of Marcus, Peter and Paul and Andrew, in all your sins, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you've given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through the participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
To us, also your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercy, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist and Stephen, Matthias and Barnabas, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord, through whom you have continued to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere homis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have a few announcements from our pastor.
So, we have good news and bad news. The good news is that next week we will begin public masses again in most parishes that are able to put in place all of the precautions. So that is good. So we will have the ability for people to come to mass, those who feel that they are healthy and not vulnerable to the coronavirus. So that is the good news. The bad news is that we will not be able to have long masses or long sermons. That's bad news for priests. So we're going to have short sermons, and keep it short because we can't be in the room for too long, and also because, and no, not a lot of loud, long songs, because again, that's another way they say of spreading the virus. And so we will have shorter masses also because we need to get people in and out so that we can clean and sanitize the pews before masses and remark them. Not all the pews will be used for each of the mass, because only 100 will be permitted in the building at the time. We will have several simultaneous masses in the community center. We'll have an opportunity for people to make reservations to make sure that you're, you have your place in one of the masses. You can call the parish office or you can go onto the internet. We'll have a limited number of reservations, and then the rest will be for those who come early. I think that perhaps at first we won't have everyone coming, obviously, because the obligation to attend Mass has been abrogated. We're dispensed from the obligation. We don't have to go to Mass. We're not required to go to Mass until the dispensation is lifted, probably at the end of when the whole pandemic is over. The bishop will once again establish the obligation to attend Sunday Mass for Catholics in this diocese. So those are some of the announcements. Again, when you come to Mass next week, please be aware we're going to have volunteers trained, and we're actually looking for more individuals to help with these procedures. We need to offer things at the doors of the church. We will welcome people. We will ask people to keep a 6 feet distance. We will indicate the pews that are open. We will also take people's temperature. We will ask everyone to wear a mask, and also we'll provide sanitizing gel, many different things that we will be doing. And so it's gonna look a little different in the church. And Mass will be simplified, as I mentioned, shorter, without a lot of ministers and things, because the more ministers, the less people we can include in the Mass. So this is how we will continue, however, to have the live streaming of Masses as well, of course, for those who will not be coming to Mass, those who feel that they are not comfortable coming to Mass. You may watch the Mass on the internet if you prefer. We also have some other announcements. Another bit of good news is that we're going to be having a parish app. Soon we will have a opportunity for people to be in contact with the parish in this way. You can sign up for different notifications. It's going to be a wonderful way for us to communicate with parishioners. This our app will be for iPhone and Android smartphones, and it's coming soon. You will be able to have access to daily Mass readings, Catholic news, prayers, and confession reminders, bulletins, etc. So we look forward to that. We continue, of course, to have confessions and opening the church for our visiting. You can come Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 9 o'clock for that. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 9 a.m. we will be having the coming in to pray here from 9 until 10. And then also Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, we have confession times as well at 5 o'clock. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we have confessions in the parking lot. Drive up behind a screen, face-to-face. We'll have three priests, so from 5 to 6 each Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And also Saturday, of course, at 8:30 as usual. So God bless all of you, and may the Lord be with us and comfort us. Send the Holy Spirit of comfort, and may the Holy Trinity, the divine family, unite us once again as God's family.
We the priests look forward to having you return next weekend. What a great weekend it is. It'll be putting Jesus in the Eucharist at the center of our lives on Corpus Christi weekend. So you're in our prayers as always, and look forward to seeing you. And good luck getting tickets. It'll be the hottest ticket in town to come to Mass. People are going to want to come to Mass, and we're looking forward to seeing all of you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.